Good morning students, now we will solve this problem of forfeiture and reissue. The Inspire Limited invited application for issuing 2 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 20 per share. It means they have issued 2 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each at rupees 30 each. 10 rupees face value plus 20 rupees premium, so the issue amount will be 30 rupees. Understood? So here on application rupees 2 per share, they have taken only rupees 2 per share with application. On allotment rupees 13 per share including rupees 10 premium. On first call rupees 7 per share including rupees 5 premium. And on final call rupees 8 per share including rupees 5 premium. See, total of 13 plus 7 20 plus 8 plus 2 means 30. So issue amount is, issued price is rupees 30 after adding 20 rupees premium in face value rupees 10. On allotment, on first call and on final call, the installment received premium also. Now applications were received for 180,000 shares. They have issued 2 lakh equity shares, but the applications were received only for 180,000 shares. It means shares were undersubscribed. Issued shares are more and applied shares are less. Shares were allotted to all the applicants. Yogesh, a shareholder holding 5,000 shares, paid his entire share money along with the allotment money. Vishesh, a holder of 7,000 shares, failed to pay the allotment money. Afterwards, the first call was made. Vishesh paid the allotment money along with the first call money. Now, the third shareholder, Samesh, holding 2,000 shares, did not pay the final call. Samesh shares were forfeited immediately after the final call. Out of the forfeited shares, 1,500 shares were reissued at rupees 8 per share fully paid up. Means the shares were reissued at discount of rupees 2. Okay. So here, 3 shareholders are involved. Yogesh is the first shareholder who has paid entire share money with allotment money. So his call money will be advanced with the company before making the call. Then Vishesh is the second shareholder. He failed to pay the allotment money. So his money will be arrears at the time of allotment money. But afterwards the first call was made and Vishesh has paid all the allotment money with the first call money. Okay, Samesh holding 2,000 shares did not pay the final call. Manje fakta Samesh ni final call bharlela nahiye. Ani because of non-payment of final call money, Samesh shares were forfeited immediately after the final call. Out of forfeited 2,000 shares of Samesh, 1,500 shares were reissued at rupees 8 per share fully paid up. So we have to pass the necessary journal entries in the books of the Inspire Limited. So let's start now. Okay, so let's pass the journal entries of the Inspire Limited. In this problem, they told us that there is under subscription of shares. The company wanted to issue 2 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 20 per share. But applications for 180,000 shares were received. Okay, we will do some working with table is not necessary because there is no oversubscription and pro rata allotment in this problem. So some basic working notes we can solve on this paper. Application money received will be on 180,000 shares into the application money is rupees 2 per share. So rupees 3,60,000 will be the application money received. Okay. Now the second working will be of every shareholder. In this problem, every shareholder is doing different things. First shareholder Yogesh. He is holding 5,000 shares, paid his entire share money along with the allotment money. Okay, so entire money paid with allotment. So we will calculate entire money means which amount is paid by him. He is holding 5,000 shares. Okay, on first call he has paid first call money on 5,000 shares. That is 5,000 into the first call money is rupees 7 per share. So into 7, that is 35,000 of first call he has paid with allotment. Then final call, on final call 5,000 shares into the final call amount is 8 rupees per share. So 40,000 rupees he has paid with allotment. It means he has paid total amount 75,000 with allotment at the time of allotment. That is the entire amount on his shares. Okay, now let's calculate the allotment money actually received at the time of allotment. Total, otherwise we can also solve third step as the other shareholders arrears. Other is Vishesh. Purcha shareholder Vishesh na acha hai. On 7,000 shares he failed to pay the allotment money. So Vishesh calls in arrears is equal to 7,000 shares into failed to pay the allotment money, and allotment money is rupees 13. So he has failed to pay 91,000 at the time of allotment. But afterwards the first call was made and Vishesh paid the allotment money along with the first call money. Okay, so these 91,000 amount is not paid at the time of allotment, but this amount is paid after making the first call with first call money. Understood? So now we will calculate the allotment money actually received at the time of the entry. So allotment money due is equal to 180,000 into 13 rupees, that is 23,40,000. That is correct, 23,40,000. But this amount is due at the time of allotment. पण या अमाउंट बरोबरच हा जो योगेश आहे त्यांनी अलॉटमेंट बरोबर सगळे पैसे भरून टाकलेत. सो ॲड कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्सेस ऑफ योगेश. सो वी हॅव टू ॲड 75,000 इन धिस अमाऊंट. सो टोटल विल बी 24,15,000. Correct, 24,15,000. Now this amount is receivable, but Vishesh has not paid allotment money, so his arrears will be deducted, less calls in arrears of Vishesh, that is 91,000. And the amount actually received at the time of allotment money received will be 23,24,000 received. Okay, understood? Now we will calculate first call money received. See, amount receivable on first call is equal to 180,000 shares into the first call money is rupees 7, so the multiplication will be 12,60,000. First call money 12,60,000 mein aayla hava hota. बट दे टोल्ड अस दैट विशेष पेड द अलॉटमेंट मनी अलॉन्ग विथ द फर्स्ट कॉल. मीन्स विशेषनी जे कॉल सीन एरियस 91,000 rupees अमाउंट रिसिवेबल वॉज 12,60,000 एंड विशेष हैज पेड द 91,000 अमाउंट दैट इज कॉल सीन एरियस ऑन अलॉटमेंट विथ फर्स्ट कॉल. ओके सो अमाउंट रिसीव्ड कैलक्युलेट करता ऐक्चुअल अमाउंट किती रिसीव झालेली असेल तर रिसिवेबल 12,60,000 होती बट ऐड कॉल्स इन एरियर्स ऑफ विशेष वन शेयर होल्डर विच इज 91,000 सो टोटल विल बी 13,51,000. ओके पण ही अमाउंट रिसीव होणार नाही कारण फर्स्ट कॉल मनीपैकी हा जो योगेश आहे त्यांनी फर्स्ट कॉलचे 35,000 अमाउंट ऑलरेडी पेड केलेली आहे त्यामुळे ती आत्ता रिसीव होणार नाही ती कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्स अकाउंटचे ॲडजस्ट करावे लागतील. सो लेस कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्स तुम्हाला कळतंय मी इथे लेस करून दाखवते आहे याचं कारण ते ऑलरेडी रिसिव्ड आहे ती फक्त ॲडजस्ट करायची फर्स्ट कॉल बरोबर आत्ता अमाऊंट रिसीव किती झाली ते आपण काढतो आहे. सो वी हॅव टू डिडक्ट द अमाऊंट विच इज ऑलरेडी रिसिव्ड ऑन धिस कॉल. सो आफ्टर डिडक्टिंग 35,000 13,16,000 अमाऊंट ॲक्च्युअल रिसिव्ड ॲट द टाईम ऑफ फर्स्ट कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड एंट्री. ओके दिस इज द केस ऑफ फर्स्ट कॉल मनी. नाव फायनल कॉल रिसिवेबल इन दिस वे वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट फायनल कॉल मनी रिसिवेबल. सी दे टोल्ड अस दॅट समेश होल्डिंग 2,000 शेअर्स डीड नॉट पे द फायनल कॉल. समेशनी 2,000 शेअर्सवरचा फायनल कॉल भरलेला नाही आहे आणि हा जो विशेष आहे सॉरी विशेष नाही योगेश हां योगेश आहे त्यांनी 40,000 ऑलरेडी भरून टाकलेले आहेत त्यामुळे फायनल कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड करताना ते 40,000 आपल्याला ऑलरेडी रिसिव्ड आहेत असं दाखवावं लागेल आणि त्यांनी न भरलेले डिडक्ट करावे लागतील. ओके सो नाव लेट्स कॅल्क्युलेट फायनल कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड. अमाउंट ऑफ फायनल कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड अमाउंट रिसिवेबल इज इक्वल टू 1,80,000 इन टू द फायनल कॉल मनी इज रुपीज 8 सो द अमाउंट विल बी 14,40,000. ओके नाव वी हॅव टू डिडक्ट द कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्स सो लेस कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्स मनी कारण ते ऑलरेडी रिसीव झालेले आहेत. सो वी हॅव टू डिडक्ट द कॉल्स इन ॲडव्हान्स 40,000 इट विल बी 14,00,000. ओके नाव लेस द कॉल्स इन ॲरियर्स ऑफ द थर्ड शेअर होल्डर दॅट इज समेश ही हॅज फेल्ड टू पे द फायनल कॉल ऑन 2,000 शेअर्स सो 2,000 इन टू 8 दॅट इज 16,000 सो ॲक्च्युअल अमाऊंट रिसिव्ड ॲट द टाईम ऑफ फायनल कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड इज 13,84,000 जस्ट लाईक ऑन फर्स्ट कॉल मनी रिसिव्ड. ओके सो अमाऊंट्स ऑफ एव्हरी एंट्री वी हॅव कॅल्क्युलेटेड सो द material is ready. Now let's pass the journal entries. First entry will be of application money received. So bank account debit rupees 3,60,000 we have already calculated that 3,60,000 to equity share application account $3,60,000 and narration is application money received on 180,000 shares at rupees 2 each. Now the second entry will be of application money received. At the time of application there was no problem, so application money will be received in full. So the entry will be equity share application account debit to equity share capital account. Amount is 360,000 because there were no arrears obviously in this application money, and कारण ॲप्लिकेशन झाल्याशिवाय पुढचं काम होऊ शकत नाही, त्यामुळे ॲप्लिकेशन मनी फुल्ली रिसिव्ड. ओवर सबस्क्रिप्शन नसल्यामुळे रिफंड देणं किंवा प्रोरेटा अलॉटमेंट केलेली असल्यामुळे अलॉटमेंटबरोबर ट्रान्सफर करणं अलॉटमेंट अकाउंटला वगैरे काही इथे असणार नाही. सो ॲप्लिकेशन मनी ट्रान्सफर्ड टू कॅपिटल अकाउंट. This will be the narration. Now the third entry. Third entry will be allotment money due, and here with allotment there is 10 rupees premium, means original amount is rupees 3 plus premium 10. In this way 13 rupees per share amount is receivable from 180,000 shares. Okay, so equity share allotment account debit we have calculated allotment money due 23,40,000. So to equity share capital account to security premium reserve account. Now on equity share capital 180,000 into original amount, that is rupees 3 each on 180,000, so amount will be 5,40,000, and security premium will be per share rupees 10, so 180,000 into rupees 10, that is 18,00,000. रिनाउंड कंपनी असेल तर प्रीमियम जास्त असतो. सो अलॉटमेंट मनी ड्यू विथ सिक्युरिटी प्रीमियम, दिस विल बी द नॅरेशन इन दिस एंट्री. ओके, नाव द एंट्री ऑफ अलॉटमेंट मनी रिसिव्ड. ओके, see on this working we have calculated the actual allotment money received is 23,24,000, and we have to show these call scenarios in the entry, and this advance paid by Yogesh together with allotment. Okay, so let's pass the entry that way. Bank account debit by the amount we have calculated, actual amount 23,24,000. Okay, then call scenarios account will be debit, that will be 7,000 shares into 13 rupees, that is we have already calculated 91,000. Okay, to equity share allotment account to calls in advance account, account 23,40,000 plus calls in advance received 75,000. Understood? This will be the entry pass. Allotment money received. With calls in advance. On 5,000 shares. And calls in arrears were on 7,000 shares. Understood? This will be the entry. They will actually received amount 23,24,000 and calls in arrears were 91,000. From that amount, 23,40,000 will be of allotment and 75,000 will be of calls in advance paid by that shareholder. Understood? Now the fifth entry. Now the fifth entry will be first call money due. So equity share, first call account. There is a lot of disturbance. Equity share first call account debit. We have already calculated this amount on the rough page. That is 12,60,000. To equity share capital account, obviously. Equity share capital account. Now in this first call there is also premium, so equity share capital will be only rupees 3,60,000 because see here call money is rupees 7 but there is 5 rupees premium. Okay, so equity share capital account will be credited by 3,60,000 and remaining will be the security premium. To security premium reserve account, that is the remaining amount 9 lakhs, means 180,000 shares into rupees 5 rupees premium. Okay, first call money due. Now the entry of first call money received. Again, in first call money received, actual received amount into bank will be 13,16,000. Okay. Then we will adjust calls in advance 35,000, which was previously credited. Now we have to debit that amount here. First call money will be 12,60,000. Okay. And the calls in arrears were rupees 91,000 previously. Will be adjusted with first call because that shareholder paid allotment money with first call. Okay, so the entry will be bank account debit 13,16,000 as we calculated earlier. Now we have to debit the calls in advance account which was previously credited by us here. Total amount from that amount 35,000 is of first call money, so we have to adjust this amount here. Calls in advance account will be debited 35,000 which was credited already to share first call account, to equity share first call account. Amount of first call will be 12,60,000 as we have calculated earlier. And to calls in arrears account, we have debited calls in arrears account in previous installment, that is at the time of allotment. See here, calls in arrears account was debited. Now we have to credit it because that shareholder paid this amount with first call money. Okay, so narration, first call money received along with calcineurias. And calcine advance adjusted. This will be the narration. Okay. Now, the seventh entry will be of final call money due. Again, in final call, there is security premium. So, entry will be equity share final call account debit. Equity share final call account debit to equity share capital account to security premium reserve account. Okay, final call money receivable, see here 14,40,000, that is 1,80,000 into 8. From that amount, equity share capital amount will be 5,40,000 again, because remaining is the security premium, and rupees 9 lakhs will be security premium. 1,80,000 into 3 will be 5,40,000 of capital, and remaining amount will be, that is rupees 5, will be the security premium per share. Okay. So, final call money due along with security premium. This will be the narration. Final call money due. शांतपणे विचार केला आपण तर आपल्याला हे कळू शकतं कोणत्या अमाउंट बरोबर कोणती अमाउंट ऍडजस्ट करायचे. वी हॅव टू कॉन्सन्ट्रेट अँड कॅल्क्युलेट carefully in this problem. Okay, now we have calculated actual amount received at the time of final call into bank will be 13,84,000. Okay, these will be the call scenarios. So bank account debit, call scenarios account will be debited. Then we will adjust advance account previously credited, so we have to debit call in advance account also. And to equity share final call will be the total amount, that is 14,40,000. Okay, so let's pass the entry. Now, bank account debit, as per our calculation, 13,84,000. Calls in arrears account debit, we have calculated the arrears, that is 16,000. Okay, calls in advance account will be debited. Upon calls in advance account debit karto hai karan to adhi credit kelela ahe, to ya final call cha poti jama karayche aplyala 40,000. Shareholder ni advance dilela hota, to ya call poti adjust zalela ahe to equity share final call account. Amount is 14,40,000. Okay, in this way we have to pass this entry here, and the narration will be final call money received and calls in arrears and calls in advance adjusted accordingly. This will be the narration. Understood? Now the 8th entry. Now we will pass 9th entry. Okay. Though they told us that the 2000 shares on which the amount is not paid of final call was forfeited. It means 2000 shares were forfeited for non-payment of final call. So we have to pass the entry of forfeiture now, and all we know what will be the entry, okay? So equity share capital account debit, equity share capital account debit will called up amount ni 2000 shares forfeited, all the money that is face value 10 has been called up, so amount will be 20,000, okay? Then त्या शेअरहोल्डरनी फायनल कॉल मनीवरचा कॉलसिन सॉरी फायनल कॉलवरचा प्रीमियम सिक्युरिटी प्रीमियम रिझर्व भरलेला नाही सो सिक्युरिटी प्रीमियम रिझर्व अकाउंट डेबिट ऑन 2000 शेअर्स इंटू रुपीज 5 दॅट इज 10,000 टू कॉलसिन एरियर्स अकाउंट His arrears we have calculated already are 16,000. Two, share forfeiture account, that is forfeited shares account. Forfeited shares account will be, he has paid on 2000 shares. Application money, allotment money and first call money excluding premium. Application money per share forfeited shares account 2000 shares into application money is rupees 2 allotment money is rupees 3 excluding premium and first call money was rupees 2 excluding premium so 2 plus 3 plus 2 mithe lite 2 plus 3 plus 2 that means 7 okay 7 rupees into 2000 means 14,000. So forfeited amount will be 14,000 of on those shares. Understood? Now 2000 equity shares forfeited for non-payment of final call money. This will be the entry of forfeiture. इथे लिहिते entry of forfeiture. This is the entry of forfeiture. Okay. Now the 10th entry. They told us that these shares were reissued at rupees 8 per share fully paid up. So entry of reissue now. So the entry will be bank account debit. They have reissued 1500 shares only from those 2000 shares. So 1500 into 8 will be 12,000. Then share forfeited shares account debit. As these shares were reissued at rupees 8, it means discount given rupees 2 on 1500 shares. So 1500 shares into 2, that is rupees 3000 will be taken from forfeited shares account to equity share capital account. Amount will be 15,000. 1500 shares reissued at rupees 8 per share fully paid up. Okay, this will be the entry of reissue. Now the entry will be of capital reserve, amount transferred to capital reserve, that is capital gain of the company due to reissue will be transferred to capital reserve account. So forfeited shares account debit to capital reserve account, gain on reissue transferred to capital reserve account. This will be the narration. Now amount. On our rough paper, here we will calculate the last working note, that is 7th, capital gain transferred to capital reserve. आपल्याला कॅपिटल गेन कॅपिटल रिझर्वला किती ट्रान्सफर केला आहे ते कॅल्क्युलेट करायचे. ओके, नाव सी इयर फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट इज 14,000 ऑन ऑल शेअर्स. सो वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट पर शेअर. देअरफोर फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट पर शेअर इज इक्वल टू टोटल फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट divided by number of shares is equal to total forfeited amount is 14,000 divided by number of shares 2,000. So rupees 7 will be per share forfeited amount, and they have reissued 1,500 shares. So 1,000 forfeited amount on 1,500 shares is equal to 1,500 into rupees 7, that is 10,500 rupees. Okay, from this 10,500 rupees, discount given, it means 1,500 शेअर्स रिइश्यू केलेले आहेत, त्याच्या वाटणीची फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट या 14,000 पैकी 10,500 एवढी आहे. या 10,500 पैकी अमाऊंट 1,500 शेअर्स रिइश्यू करताना डिस्काउंट दिला आहे त्याच्यासाठी वापरली जाईल. सो डिस्काउंट गिवन लेस करायचं आहे आपल्याला, 10,500 डिस्काउंट गिवन रुपीज 3,000. देअरफोर 10,500 मायनस 3,000 विल बी 7,500 विल बी द गेन ऑन रिइश्यू. तुम्हाला कळतं आहे का? बघा, 14,000 ही पूर्ण फॉरफिटेड ती अमाऊंट आहे जी 2,000 शेअर्सवरची आहे. बरोबर आहे? म्हणून आपल्याला रिइश्यू केलेल्या शेअर्सवरची फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट काढायचे. रिइश्यू केलेले शेअर्स 1,500 आहेत, म्हणून आपण पर शेअर फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट काढली आणि रिइश्यू केलेल्या शेअर्सनी मल्टिप्लाय करून रिइश्यू केलेल्या शेअर्सची फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट 10,500 आहे. या 10,500 पैकी 3,000 डिस्काउंट द्यायला वापरण्यात आलेली आहे, म्हणजे उरलेत अजून त्या शेअर्सची वाटणीची फॉरफिटेड अमाऊंट 7,500, विच इज गेन, कॅपिटल गेन ऑफ द कंपनी, विच विल बी ट्रान्सफर्ड टू कॅपिटल रिझर्व अकाउंट. ओके, सो 7,500. इन दिस वे वी हॅव टू प्रिपेअर द वर्किंग इन दिस प्रॉब्लेम. हियर आय हॅव प्रिपेअर्ड ए डिटेल वर्किंग नोट. वर्किंग नोट शुड बी पार्ट ऑफ युअर आन्सर. सो पेपरमध्ये जिथे प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व करू आपण तिथेच वर्किंग नोट सॉल्व करायचे आपल्याला आणि जर्नल एंट्रीज करायच्या आहेत. ओके, इन दिस वे वी हॅव टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लेम. दॅट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे.